Hello, welcome to any TVN channel. It's a mistake if your Eve Lab doesn't have a Windows virtual machine. In this video, I will show you how to install Windows 10 in an Eve virtual environment. First, you need to prepare a Windows 10 ISO file. Next, you copy and paste the ISO file into Eve using WinSCP. OptoNetLab AddinSchemu. You create a new folder according to Eve's naming convention. Here I name it Win-10. Note that you must not name the wrong convention. Next, drag and drop the ISO file into the newly created folder. You rename the ISO file to crom.iso. Next, you open a command window, access Eve with SSH. OptoNetLab AddinSchemu Win-10. You create a new hard drive for the Windows 10 virtual machine. You can completely perform the previous steps using the command line according to the instructions. Here you are instructed to create a hard drive of size 30 GB, because I installed Windows 10 so I increased the size to 40 GB. Next, you create a new lab and name it as you like. I created a new lab named Win-10. In the device list, I go to the Windows category and add a new computer. Next, you connect the virtual computer to the internet to update, install software or check a network connection. You start the computer and start installing the Windows 10 operating system. You won't find the hard drive like when you install Windows 10 on a real machine. To find the hard drive, click Load Driver, Browse Floppy Disk Drive. Storage 2003 R2 AMD 64. Click OK, then click Next. Wait a while, you will see the hard drive appear and you install Windows 10 on it. The next installation steps will be the same as on a physical computer, so I will fast forward the steps so you don't have to wait too long. At this point, you have installed Windows 10 for the virtual machine, but you still have an important step to take, so don't rush to turn off the video. Please follow the next steps. So the virtual machine works fine, has an internet connection. Next, you turn off the virtual machine and move on to the next step. You go to lab details and write down the UUID information. Next, find out the pod ID of your used and the node ID of your newly installed node. As in this video, pod ID is 0. Here is a sample command with the information you need to find. You right-click on the newly created virtual machine to find the node ID, and as you can see, the node ID is 1. You use the information you find to complete the command. You right-click on the newly created virtual machine to find the node ID, and as you can see, the node ID is 1. Next, you create the image from the Windows virtual machine created in the previous step. You notice the change in the size of the file virtia.cow2, which will increase in size after completion. And here is the image file you obtained. It will take you about 5 minutes to complete this step, so please wait patiently. Now you can remove Windows 10 ISO file from Eve. Finally, you start the Windows 10 virtual machine and check if it works. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.